There's a huge number of autistic people who are underemployed or unemployed. And some of the issues therein are because of some of the barriers that are in place for them. Things like a job interview, which is a very stressful, anxiety-inducing situation. So if we can use virtual reality as a place to help these people perform and to sort of rehearse, if you will, and to understand what that environment might feel and look like, I think that's where those technologies can help bridge that barrier. So one of the things that we're really keen to do here is take the technology from the research lab into schools and into the community and into the homes and the places where autistic people can actually use this stuff.
We are a small school, and we've always known from the beginning that community partnerships would be an important part of the program we offer here, because it provides our kids with so much more outside of school, and everything Dr. Nigel presented fit into that perfectly. Partnering with him, partnering with UF, would be able to provide things that we couldn't provide.
This population doesn't get listened to as much as it could or should within research context, so we're really keen to make sure we position that voice centrally to the work we do. So we give people the opportunity to use the technology, and then we engage in conversations, things like focus groups and interviews. That's where our research questions come from. I then work with autistic groups right the way through the research process. So it's not just at that point, but it's actually throughout the research process. This isn't necessarily mainstream as it could be, I don't think, certainly in the future. So my future ambition is that these technologies are in every school, they're in every space where autistic people can sort of take benefit from them, and that they continue to support them in their ambitions around employment, education, and independent living.
The first time I played it, I was a little nervous, but once I got the hang of it, I was slashing the red and blue and I was just having fun.
There's like some stuff that I don't know about VR that Dr. Nigel is showing me.
Just knowing that they had a voice and that their opinions mattered, and someone who wanted to listen to them, to hear from the students, these young adults who have very, you know, strong opinions about different things. And then also the parents, to really know what type of technology would be usable, would be useful, would be practical.
Being able to stand back and see the teachers and the young people or the parents interacting with one another and with the technology or through the technology, that for me is the thing that brings the sort of biggest smile to my face.